Hey guys, in this tutorial we're going to talk about in a parabola, if I give you the y coordinates, can you give me the x coordinate of the graph? So let's have a look at this graph which we drew previously in Graphmatica, and the equation was y equals x squared plus 5x plus 6. And let's say I wanted to know that when y was equal to 2, what's x? Now let's have a look at this graph and let's have a look at where y equals 2 is. So this is the y-axis, and y is equal to 2 will be about here. So when y is equal to 2, x is equal to either negative 4 or negative 1. So there are two answers. So x is equal to negative 4 or negative 1. Now let's try another number. When y is equal to 4, what does x equal to? So now let's go to where y is 4 on the graph. When y is equal to 4, again, there are two answers for when y is 4. X is equal to about negative 0.5 according to our graph. And there's another answer about negative 4.5. So you can see that when I give you a y coordinate, you can actually give me two answers for the x coordinate because it's a parabola. The only difference would be the turning points where there is only one x-coordinate for that y value, for that y-coordinate. Okay, so as you can see, it's quite hard to use a graph to give you an exact accurate number, right? Negative 0.5, I pretty much estimated that from just looking at the graph. I don't have any solid proof other than my eyes to say that that is the accurate value. So we need to know how to do this algebraically. Well, let's try the easiest one. Let's make y equals to 0. So when y equals 0, what's x? And according to our graph, when y is equal to 0, which would be here, right, vertically, when y is equal to 0, we have x is negative 2 and negative 3. So how we solve that algebraically is if we get the equation of the graph, y equals x squared plus 5x plus 6, and we make y equal to 0. We substitute 0 into the equation for y. So 0 equals x squared plus 5x plus 6. The next thing you need to do is factorize this equation. And if you're not sure how to do that, there's another video in the year 8 to 10 section that teaches you how to factorize a quadratic equation. So basically, by factorizing, we have this equals x plus 2 in brackets and x plus 3 in brackets. Once we have factorized it, then using the null factor theorem, which says that if a times b is equal to 0, then either a is equal to 0 or b is equal to 0. And this makes sense because if you think of two numbers that multiply together to give you 0, then one of them has to be 0. So for example, 5 times 0 is 0, or 0 times 10 is 0, and so on. So whenever you have two numbers that multiply to give you 0, one of them has to be 0. So that means in this equation here, we have the first term, which is x plus 2, multiply by the second term, x plus 3, so one of them has to be 0. So either x plus 2 is 0 or x plus 3 is 0. When x plus 2 equals 0, what's x? Well, we're going to minus 2 on both sides. So if you minus 2 on both sides, the positive and negative 2 cancel each other out, so we have x equals negative 2. And the same thing happens here. We're going to minus 3 on both sides, so x equals negative 3. So these are your answers, x equals negative 2 and x equals negative 3. And you can see that it matches our x-intercepts, x equals negative 2 and negative 3 on our graph. So when y is equal to 0, x is equal to negative 2 and negative 3. Now, what if back to our graph, I'm just going to delete some of this stuff. So back in our graph, what if I wanted to know when y is equal to 2, what's x? Now according to this graph, it's about negative 1 and negative 4. Okay, so I'm going to write out the equation. When y is equal to 2, 2 equals x squared plus 5x plus 6, right? Because we've substituted the number 2 into our equation. Now, what you want to do is try to solve this equation now by making everything go to the right-hand side. So we have 0 equals x squared plus 5x plus 4. And so what did I do here to make that happen? Well, basically I minus 2 on both sides. And you can see that 2 minus 2 is 0, 6 minus 2 is 4. And then, so we have this equation here, and you can factorize it again. So that factorizes into x plus 1, x plus 4 equals 0. Using the null factor theorem, you can see that x plus 1 is equal to 0, or x plus 4 is equal to 0. Solving these two linear equations, you get x equals negative 1 or x equals negative 4. So that's done. So we can see that this matches our graph again. When y is equal to 2, x is equal to negative 1 and negative 4. Now this method only works when the coordinates are whole numbers. So let's try another example when the coordinates are not whole numbers. So if you have a look here, when y is equal to 3, what's x? And when y is equal to 3, which is about here, x is not a whole number. X is about somewhere between negative 0.5 and negative 1. And here it's somewhere between negative 4 and negative 4.5. So we're not sure what it is, but it's definitely not a whole number for x. So what we're going to do now is again write our equation out, substitute the number 3 into y. So 3 equals x squared plus 5x plus 6. And we're going to rearrange the equation so that all the terms are on the right hand side. And we have 0 equals x squared plus 5x plus 3. So I've subtracted 3 on both sides, which made the 3 go on the which turned the 3 into 0. Okay, now we want to solve this equation using the quadratic formula, which says that when x when ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0, then x is equal to negative b plus or minus b squared minus 4ac under a square root over 2a. Now, this formula is actually quite easy to memorize after you've used it a few times. So you just have to memorize that one, unfortunately. Okay, so we have in our equation, a is equal to 1 because a is in front of the x squared. B is equal to 5 because b is in front of x, and c is equal to 3. So solving that equation, we now need to put a, b, and c into our quadratic formula. So b is a 5 plus minus 5 squared minus 4 times 1 times 3, because a is 1 and c is 3, over 2 times 1. So putting all that into the quadratic formula, and let's type, so let's get the numbers in under the square root calculated. So 5 squared is 25 minus 4 times 3 is 12 over 2. So that makes it negative 5 plus or minus square root of 13 over 2. So putting that in the calculator, we have negative 5 plus square root of 13 over 2, or negative 5 minus square root of 13 over 2. That's what the plus and minus mean, because it means you can either plus or minus. So we're gonna do, we're gonna try both and see what happens. And so putting that in the calculator, negative 5, so negative 5 plus the square root of 13 and divided by 2, so that's negative 0.697, rounded to 3dp, or negative 5, negative 5 minus the square root of 13 divided by 2, which is negative 4.3. What was that? Negative 4.302. Again, round it to 3 decimal places. And now let's check that against our graph. So when y is equal to 3, x should be equal to negative 0.6 and negative 4.3. So that matches our graph, because when y is equal to 3, which is about here, x is equal to negative, go down a straight line, which is about there, which is about negative 0.697. And here, if you go down from y is equal to 3, x is about negative 4.303. So it matches again our graph. So basically, if you're given a y coordinate, there are a couple of things you should try. Number one is try factorizing. Now, that won't always work when the answer is not a whole number. So if that doesn't work, then you can use the quadratic formula. Quadratic formula. Okay, so thanks for watching the tutorial on how to find the x-coordinate given the y-coordinate in a quadratic equation. See you next time.